What's up, guys? Let's go Pen 17. You might be thinking, oh my gosh, that's the worst camera quality in the entire world. And yes, you'd be right. I'm using my camera on my laptop. How fun is that? But, I'm not trying to get all fancy when I'm... But, let's just be honest, you know? There's a lot of things that get on people's nerves, and some with video, some people have to have perfect quality, perfect microphone, nothing. I just want the audio, because the audio is more important. And speaking of things that get on people's nerves, that's the topic of today's video. You know, I feel like you don't need to see me for this video, but, so I'm just going to sit here and eat my candy and give you five reasons why most people hate school. This goes off of my public school, so just chill. I am a junior, okay? I'm a junior. So, keep that in mind. It's off of my school. Some of the stuff may not happen at your school. And if it does, you and I are in the same boat. Buddies for life. There we go. Yeah. But, this... I originally got the, thing to get do this video because I just had, like, the worst day at school ever. And so, that being said... Here I am, making a 5 Reasons Why video, and we're going to get to it right now. Okay, so, this one, for me, is ranked at 5, but it also does piss me off a lot. It was hard to pick just 5, but this is what I came out with. Number 5, though, on reasons why I hate going to school and why everybody hates going to school. Too early, and it's too long, alright? So, I don't know about y'all, but for me, my schedule consists of, on a school day, doing this. Getting up at 5 in the morning to make sure everything's all set up, okay? And then, I have to get up so that early, first of all. And then, I have to go to the bus at 7 in the morning to get on the crowded bus, okay, to go to school. It starts at 8 o'clock, okay? Now I gotta wait and do all this other garbage, in which I will talk about and... the next 4. I gotta deal with all this other garbage, right? And then I get out at 3 o'clock. What is that? 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3. 7 hours of doing stupid stuff, okay? Which is dumb. I know that I need an education, but too early. I wake up too early, and then I get to school. I end up having tests period 1 and 2, and I'm not even awake at that time, you know? Not like I don't go to bed at a reasonable hour. I do. And it's stupid, you know? So, and then I sit there and deal with all the other garbage I'm about to explain to you for 7 hours. Not a fan, you know, at all. They gotta either make it not early or make it less long. Because in this regard, I also don't want to go to school at like 6 o'clock at night, 7 o'clock at night and get out. It's stupid. See, we can thank Department of Education in Pennsylvania for making... let's have 180 days of school, 7 hours a day. It's dumb. And, like, let's just be honest, you know? Most of us hate it. Most of us don't even want to be there. So, why are you making it that long? Why can't we just get to the bare minimum stuff we need to get done, and that's it? I don't understand why we need 7 hours. It's beyond me. But let's go to the next one. Number 4. Jock asshole rich kids. I hate it. All right. So, the school that I go to, I have a bunch of rich kids around me. Because our school is a rich kid school. But, it does not necessarily mean everybody there is rich. Okay? I'm currently looking out my window, and I can see the opening of one development of, like, the four that are around here that supply our kids. And there's one, another one down the street. Okay? So, there's those guys. There's people down by the bowling alley. Okay? That's three. And then, if we go down the main street, there's another one all the way down there. At our line with the other school that we up, there we are. We are bordered around by, like, a lot of schools. So, but there's a border that way. And there's another one down there. That's four. And these kids in these developments, right? They act like they can do everything, okay? Read my shirt, if you can, with the terrible camera. It says Dallas Marching Band. I am a marching band member. I am the drumline captain. I've been playing the drums since I was four. And, you know, I'm interested in music. Needless to say, I'm going to college for music. Doing all that stuff. I'm a band geek. But I'm not necessarily a geek because I have glasses and I like music. I'm also pretty athletic, okay? Pretty fast. Pretty strong, even though it doesn't look like it. I got the fastest metabolism in the world. And, I'm still strong and I don't understand it. Even though it looks like I can't even lift a straw. But, believe you me, I'm still pretty athletic. But, the thing that pisses me off is it gets from these people, these really fortunate kids who lives up in these, developments, big houses. There's a plastic surgeon's kid who goes to my school, okay? Also, there's a kid whose dad owns a car dealership, a major car dealership in my area. He drives a GT to our school. And there's another kid who's a doctor's kid. He graduated. But he drove an Audi R8 to school every day. These kids are ridiculous. What do they do in school that I don't like and that a lot of other kids don't like? They're jerks. They are assholes, okay? You'll walk in there. They don't like our band. They really, really don't, okay? They hate us. The one thing that I hate about being a band kid is that we don't get respect. We're not on the football team. We're not, even if you're a girl, you're not on the field hockey team or the basketball team. So therefore, you're shit. People pick on the other nerds, and people have their own things, you know. We're all different, you know. I like music, okay? Well, and this is hypothetical. Maybe my friend Billy likes football. I like band, he likes football. We can still be friends, right? Me and Billy are still friends, right? But because somebody else on the football team says, I'm a band kid, Billy, you can't be friends with him. He's a band kid. He's such a nerd, and they pick on you. And nowadays, we have this. You know what this is? This is a cell phone, okay? For all of you older people that are watching, okay? Oh, what's that? You don't have the brand new iPhone? What's this? This is an iPhone 4. If I walked in with this, I don't walk in with this every day. This is an iPhone 4. I record sometimes on this, but it's dead at the moment, and I'm trying to fix it. iPhone 4. You walk in with this today, and it's not the iPhone XR plus ABCDEFG, and it's, oh, you can't afford none, and they'll take pictures of you when you're not looking, you have a different opinion than them, they'll freaking destroy you. You're done. They won't leave you alone, because you're different, or because you can't afford the latest thing. These rich asshole kids, and the girls, oh, my gosh, I can't even begin to tell you, okay? So, hypothetically, I'll actually tell you a real story. Never mind. My girlfriend, she's on the soccer team. She's quite good. But my question is this. People get after her, okay? Even though Because she's friends with kids who aren't popular. Can people be friends with whoever the hell they want to be with? Because that's not bothering anybody, is it? It's not bugging anybody. You know? Why is it that we out here, you know, we out here trying to fit this narrative like, oh, I'm a popular kid, I'm a starter on the football team. I can't be friends with a band kid. I can't be nice to them. I can't be nice to the kid who likes to read. I can't be nice to the silent kid in the back because he's too scared to talk to anybody because I'm an asshole. No. You will find it in my school to be very, very, very rare if there's a football player who's nice to a band kid. The only reason that sometimes I even get a high five from them if I'm just walking in the hallway is because I cover their games on the media. That's the only reason. And a lot of these other band kids have been treated terribly. A lot of these other girls that like read and they like do different things like for the Key Club or your student council. That's a thing now. Student council is now only for those kids, those rich kids. Because if you're a nerd like me who does nothing but write quarter notes and eighth notes on a paper all day, that's what I do. But if I tried to go into one of those student council meetings and represent myself, just be like, here's what I think we should do, they'd completely disregard me because I'm a band kid. And people obviously know that these teachers see it. They see these kids getting bullied in the hallway. People are videotaping. It's not even flat out bullying, shoving people in lockers anymore. It's, oh, let's videotape him. That was my wallet. Let's videotape them. Ha, this is funny. I'll put this on my Snapchat for the entire world to see. They do it to everyone. If you're not the cool jock kid that can afford the Audi R8 and the iPhone ABCDEFG, numbers 1 through 10, you know, then what the hell? You obviously aren't worth anything. I'm just going to make fun of you. That's the logic in our school. That's exactly what I hate about our school. And we've got 3 more to go. So I'm a little short on time, so I'm just going to keep blowing through them. Here's number 3. So, I feel like I didn't say enough about the teachers, and this isn't really the teacher's fault, but for some odd reason, they back it up like it's their idea. I feel like we don't learn the things essentially that we need. You know, I think the things, the basic things that we need are basic science, basic math, history, and in English. Why are we reading books? Why are we reading books? Okay? I don't understand this at all with the English, first of all. We're gonna go off on the English thing now. So it's like, and I think we should also have music. I think every kid should have music because it's scientifically proven and studies have shown that kids, for all these kids that have to get freaking 100s and argue with the teacher to get 100s, and they have to be so smart, here's the deal, okay? Graduation rates for kids in college who take at least one music class during their college career, whether they're trying to major in it or not, you know, watch this, okay? This is my keyboarding book. There was a piano class that we take, if you want to, whenever you can. I took it in 9th grade, okay? Let me get to the point where the place that I got to. Because this is only book 1. You can't see it. But I like music. That's great. Okay? We should take classes that we love to take. But there's also these classes like trig and geometry and calculus. That's great to have, okay? I'm not bashing math because it's stupid or whatever. I'm saying, when am I going to use it in life? Unless I want to be a mathematician. You know, for math, for me, for what I want to do, I just got to be able to count. You know? You don't see us automatically being required to take classes Like how, like teaching us how to pay our bills. Like teaching us how to replace a tire on the side of the street if you break down on the highway or whatever. You don't get those classes. You have to sign up for those classes, and you're lucky if you get the classes that you want. But we have to know what happens in photosynthesis and shit. Here's what I think we need. We need a math every year. And not pointless math either. Part of math should be how to pay your bills and stuff. Not just, I mean, after you get through elementary school and middle school, you know, you can do that stuff. You can start getting a little bit more complex. But what the hell do we need? Why do we have to take things? I know how to count. I know how to do my basic four, adding, subtracting, multiplying, and dividing. I know how to do exponents. I know PEMDAS. I know fractions, decimals, lots of algebra. You know, all of this bullshit. 3.14, whatever, pi, you know, that garbage. I don't need it, really. That's great, okay? And I'm proud of the kids who are actually taking calculus and all this stuff and going into college and being all like, yeah, this is really easy. That's great. But what the hell for the rest of us? We shouldn't be required to read Shakespeare in English class. We should learn how to type essays or emails or stuff like that. The English language, they always say, is the hardest language ever. Ever. You know, it's always one of the hardest, most complex languages. Now, what the hell are we doing reading stories? Why the hell are we reading stories if we out here speaking the hardest language and lots of kids have speech impediments? Why can't we just focus on trying to fix people's speech or writing an essay for college? Because we know all these smart kids are going to need to do that for college. And what about typing an email to your boss if you're going to go to the workforce? You know? We got all of this stuff going on. But no, reading Shakespeare, which is, I don't get me wrong, I'm not completely against reading Shakespeare and Shakespearean English and all that garbage and reading plays and books. But what's going to help me more in the future? You know? What's going to help me more? Okay? Reading a story, answering the questions, writing it down on a piece of paper, or actual learning on how to write an essay, how to write an email, punctuation, this and that, getting into details. There's a lot of stuff we still don't know about our language. As my generation, we don't know about our language. And we're learning in school, but instead, we're learning about all of this other trash, like the fact that Pete the Cat walked up the street. What's the irony in that, you know? English teachers are out here reading something, okay? Cat walked up the street. And English teachers, even though there's no significance to it, will be like, what's the significance to this? We need to write this down in our notes. What the hell do we care? That's not helping me learn English. That's not helping me speak, okay? That's not helping me at all. On to math. What am I going to do? Somebody give me a calculus problem. Somebody's going to pull me over and give me a calculus problem on the street. Is that a police officer just going to pull me over and give me a calculus problem? Because I don't see any other way that I'm going to use calculus or trigonometry or really geometry, because I know my basic shapes and that's about it. And that's really all I need, isn't it? And listen, I still have years of education to go, and I'm not saying that I'm not going to learn it soon, but like, do I need it though? Like, hold on. Newspaper, right? I can read all of the numbers on this newspaper. You know? I can read all the numbers. I can count the weather. I can read all these. I can read the words. But I'm telling you, we keep wasting all of our time on E equals MC squared. But in reality, not a lot of us are going to be mathematicians, and not a lot of us are going to be scientific people, you know? Not a lot of us are going to be English teachers, okay? I'm going to be a band teacher, an orchestra and choir. I'm going to be a musical teacher. I am. No one's changing my mind. But, and all I need is to know how to count to four. Or, no, actually, I really just need to know how to count as high as I possibly go. And I need to know how to pay my taxes. We don't hear anything about, oh, I take my, what do you learn in this class, son? Oh, I learned about reading a book and writing questions on a piece of paper. You don't hear, what'd you learn about today in this class, son? Oh, I learned how to fix a flat tire. I learned how to pay my bills. I learned about the law today. You know, you have to ask for those classes, and most of the time you don't even get them. But we out here taking trigonometry and saying it's required. I don't feel like we learn the correct things. Don't get me wrong, we need the things we learn nowadays, but we need more of life skills in our schooling, and that's just me. So let's get on to the next one. Number two, this is a controversial topic because I know that there's a lot of kids who think it's fun and cool to do. But there's a lot of kids that, you go think about it. Now, this has been happening for decades now. And it's evolved over time. But let's just say, back in the 80s and 90s, it's let's smoke cigarettes in the bathroom, okay? Now, it's let's vape in the bathroom. And if you're one specific kid in my school, let's smoke marijuana in the bathroom and get caught for it. Lots of kids think it's fun to smoke in the bathroom, do all this shit. I'm sorry. I'm trying to go in there. I'm trying to take a piss and get the hell out there because it smells in there and I don't want to be with them. Because I know that my principals are going to walk in there and they see me with these people, even me just doing my own business, not even being associated with them. If they see me in there with them, I'm going to get written up too. And I don't want to get written up because I know that if I come home, because I actually have a family that cares about me, if I come home with a write-up because I was in there with the other people doing illegal stuff, and I get sent to the magistrate, which is, by the way, what they can do now, I know that I'm going to get my butt kicked. And I'm sorry for those people who are too sensitive and are going to say that people beat me. They don't beat me. I'm just saying, I know I'd get my butt kicked if I came home getting written up because I had a vape or something. I'm tired of it. I go in that bathroom, people blowing smoke, blowing vapor everywhere. It's so stupid. We've had so many, and don't get me wrong, okay? I did vape for about a month and a half, and then I saw what people were doing, how people were slowly dying. People were digging out consolidated, like, gem things, hard rocks, out of people's lungs because of these vapes and stuff, and people are just blowing them in your face. And they're doing it to themselves. They're killing themselves. And you just say that and they're like, nah, bro, it's cool. And you get peer pressured into it. I quit after a month. I'm sorry, I quit. I couldn't do it. I thought I was being cool. It wasn't cool. I was just choking myself off. Y'all can say, oh, this is a puss. Oh, he can't take it. But let me tell you something. I'm going to be the one. I like to flex on people by not having popcorn lung. I like to flex on people by not having a nicotine addiction and not having to leave my classes. 15 minutes, I have to go to the bathrooms so I can hit it because I'm too addicted to it. I don't do all this shit. I'm not a party animal. I'm none of that. You know, I'll go out to a party once in a while, but I'll keep it low key, you know? I'm not out there with my girlfriend. We're not out there hitting it from the back. I'm not out there hitting a jewel out of her breasts. So I'm not doing any of that because I have to stay focused. There's a lot of people out here that even in the bathrooms, it's really hard to deal with. Lots of people don't care. The office makes it unenjoyable because they don't even help you when you're being bullied or harassed or nothing, and school is horrendous, and you get called out. And remember what I said about bullying, I said about bullying and people videoing you. Well, they'll put you on your Snapchat.
oh, he doesn't like vaping, watch out, he's gonna rat on all of us. Yeah, because you're slowly killing yourself, and I need to do something about it before you die, you know? Like, and I don't vape, I did vape, but I stopped, okay? And I'm trying to get other people to stop. When my girlfriend put her lips to the vape the first time, after I had stopped a while ago, I told her, I said, no, don't do it. I scared the hell out of her. Because she didn't think I knew she was doing it. I scared the hell out of her. It's going to kill you. So to those people that are watching this video right now that do vape, don't. It's not cool. I swear to you, God. I swear on my life, it is not cool. It's going to kill you. Basically, you're being used as a lab rat. Because not even the people who make those damn things really know exactly what's in them. They're just like, oh yeah, let's make it cool. Let's make these look really cool colors, or, you know, don't do it. Nicotine kill is only going to be the reason that you keep coming back, and you're gonna have popcorn lung. I swear. It pains me to know that my people that I could end up living with in the future are going to be dead because they suffocated, put water vapors. Not meant to be in your lungs. Garbage is not meant to be in your lungs. Garbage is meant to be in a trash can, and water vapor is meant to be in our skies, is a white cloud thing in the sky, you know? And it pains me because when I try to say something, then I get made fun of. But, like, I hate it. People, like, blowing their shit in my face, like, blowing their vapor shit in my face and call me a puss, and then I'm getting bullied by the entire school because I don't approve of people doing that shit. I've lost a lot of respect for a lot of people. I'm telling you that much. Let's get to the other one before I seem like too much of a puss. Oh. So number one, okay. This one couldn't be more true. And if this isn't an issue with anybody else, where do you go to school? Because I want to go. Number one. Is teachers don't realize that kids have a personal life and kids need downtime. So as I explained in the first one, I get up every single day at 5 o'clock and I don't come home till 3. Normally, I have a lot of stuff going on like a podcast and other things at nighttime. So I have a busy, busy, busy time. Yeah, on top of that, I have homework to do, which is exactly why I... I'm going to say this as my number one. So, I had an altercation with a teacher about a week and a half ago because she gave us so much homework, okay? No way we were going to get it done, okay? Didn't even give us class time to do it. Just handed it to us on the way out the door, right? And so I'm doing it. I did a little bit of it. And tried my best. I made an effort to try and finish it. I didn't get it all done. And I went to her class and I showed her what I did get done. Maybe hoping I would get a little bit of credit. Not a lot of kids had it done either. Right? And the teacher goes. She first yells at the class to be quiet. Then starts collecting the homework. Or starts checking the homework. And then she goes, I don't get paid enough to do this stuff. And then she looks at my paper, which is more done than probably anybody else's, really. And then she looks at me and goes, this is a zero. You had homework at night. You have to do it when you get home. And I said, I said the teacher's name, and then I said, you don't realize that a lot of people got a lot of stuff going on after school. We have a personal life. We need downtime as well, right? And she goes, that's not my problem. And we're like, well, listen, okay? And this teacher is a specific teacher that likes to talk about the children's mental health and how she thinks that, and she talks about all these issues that the teachers could be doing to fix the other kids' mental health. And she said, I think kids need time to do stuff. But she just yelled at me for saying that I have a personal life and I need to get things done and it's not her problem. Well, first of all, Why the hell do teachers give us homework at night? I'm a high schooler, okay? I'm a high schooler. Kids my age, you know, we high schoolers have jobs, have school sports, and don't stop. When we go home, the last thing we want to do is your bitch ass homework, because we don't care what 18 divided by 2 is, plus 1 to the square power of kiss my ass. We don't care. We don't care. Why is it? But teachers, there used to be a teacher that lived across the street from me in one of the places that I used to live with my mother. And I watched her. She goes home every day. She'd come home every night. And she would turn the TV on. And I literally would watch her, and she would not get up from the thing. Across the street, I would watch her through my window and through her window. She wouldn't get up. Nope. Wouldn't get up. The TV was just on the entire time. And she stared at it. You could watch her, look at her, watching the TV through my window into her house. She didn't get up. So teachers are allowed to have downtime and stare at the damn TV, you know. But I have to do all this homework. And that's not like it's not like to me, they give me, oh, here's this one piece of paper. I'm going to give you class time to do it, because that's when we honestly should be doing our homework. That's when they should give us. And if you don't finish it, you finish it for homework. That's reasonable. But if you're walking out the door and she goes, okay, I want pages 18 through 30 done front and back for tomorrow. And I'm just sitting there like, excuse me, do you realize that I have a personal life? Do you realize that I have to record a podcast? Which is, by the way, how I'm going to eventually be getting my income. Because, I got a lot going on. And a lot of people got stuff going on. Mindy's got a job. Leonard has a job. Mikey plays sports. I'm in the band. Those are hypothetical names. You know, lots of people got cheerleading. Some kids try to take his driver's test. Some kids got to go to the hospital to see his grandmother who's dying. But no, it's not your problem that you give us way too much fucking work and doesn't even give us time in class to do it. They don't realize we got a personal life, but they can sit home, watch the damn TV, and not move for another 7 hours until they have to get up in those 7 hours to go get a shower and come back. It's like these people got no life. And then they give us all this shit. And then they complain. They have the nerve to complain when we don't do something. Because we totally don't have a job. Or we don't only have something going on after school. We totally don't have a personal life or anything. That's what I hate. I, honest to God, I hate this. There's a lot of positives to school. One of the only reasons that I go to school is that I can hit my band class up. My chorus class up. And all the music technology classes that I'm taking. But sometimes the bad outweighs the good. And that's why I decided to make this video. So, just a quick reminder. If you are getting to the point where you hate school enough, and you want to do something to yourself, don't do it. Hang through. Just be like, I'm almost done with the year, or this and that. I'm going to say, we're going to get a break soon. We're all good. Just don't do anything stupid. Do what I do. Talk to somebody about it. Okay? Don't do anything stupid. Those are my 5 reasons. That's about it. But hold on, because I got an announcement. Okay. You see this box? I got something in this box, okay? And I got it from an anonymous person in my marching band for a Secret Santa. Okay. If you want to know what's in this box, okay?
I want this video to get 20 likes. And I know what's in this box already. It's pretty neat. I'm telling you something. Like, Patrick overhyped his box and it was a string. There's actually something in here. And it's pretty dank, I will tell you. So, if you're a meme lord, you want to know what's in this box, hit that like button. Hit the subscribe button because it helps me. Tap the bell. That way, you don't miss any other videos. Because in my other videos, I actually have good camera quality. Anyway, but that's exactly where I'm at this point. 20 likes to see what's in this box. Do it soon because I don't want this to go... I don't want anything to expire in there. But, yeah. Signing off. If I can get this candy in my mouth. Like, comment, subscribe, do everything that's good. 20 likes to see what's in the box. I'll see you all on the other side. Peace.